Hello, this is Bern, and if you are sick and tired of experiencing love problems and challenges, on today's episode, I'm going to share with you why you don't want to eliminate love problems, but what you want to do instead. So stick around. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great lifetoby.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you why you don't want to eliminate your love problems, but what is it that you really want to do in its place? So many women connect with me and they're experiencing a love problem, thinking that all they want to do is get rid of it. And what you want to do is not eliminate love problems, but transcend them in such a way that you step into higher quality problems, okay? Most human beings are under the illusion that they should not be experiencing problems, and that's not what life is for. Life is to grow and to expand and to evolve, and if you don't have challenges, you don't do any of that. You grow against challenges, against things that are difficult to do, but you actually do them so you become better. Now, there's four different qualities of problems you might, if you're a single woman, you might be experiencing. And I'm going to share them with you right now so you can self-identify where you are. And instead of saying, I want to eliminate this problem, I want you to graduate to the next level of problem. Problem number one, you don't find a guy who is compatible with you. You think that most men out there are not a fit for you, and you really can't seem to find where one who is a fit will be. You connect with guys who are not attractive to you, and the guys that you are attracted to don't seem to want you back. So that's the first base level of love problem. I don't know how to find my soulmate, and I'm not finding resonance in men, and I even have a belief that says the guy I want is not out there. So that's there's a range, right? From the most challenging to the best, but within that type of problem. So the problem with being at stage number one is that it perpetuates the cycle that what you want is not available. Here's why. Because if you start from a belief that says the guy I want is not out there, well, what you put out there is 1/10 of what you can't put out there. What you create in terms of results is very painful / shitty results. And then in turn, you start thinking, well, I was right. The guy I want is not out there. So you put even less out there. You go through this painful cycle. So that's stage number one. Stage number two is where you recognize that at some level, you take personal responsibility for the fact that if other women who are maybe not as awesome as you are creating strong connections, there's no reason why you can't. So instead of putting the problem into the guys of the world are not what I want, you say, well, there might be some guys out there who can give me what I want. And also there might be some things I can do within myself to experience joy and fulfillment and passion and excitement and transformation and alchemy within myself so that it's easier to attract, not easy, but easier to attract the kind of man that I want. So it's much less of a problem for that guy to see me from a distance and appreciate me and want me. So you step into taking personal accountability for your life, increasing your radiance and light, making sure that you are part of the solution and that you understand you're not a victim of life, but you have the power to change things. Even if it's not easy to do so, it is possible. So you start doing things that allow you to increase your radiance, increase your magnetism, create stronger connections, and experience more fulfillment, not when you connect with a guy, in the process of connecting with a guy. That's problem number two. Okay, it's still a problem. How do I do all of this? But it's a higher quality problem than how come I can't find the guy that I want, right? You're in the process of not stagnant, not feeling that it's never gonna come. Problem number three is where you've done this work for some time and then you create two or three strong options, right? You connect with guys who are showing up, who are have integrity, who are worthy, who like you, who desire you, who want to be with you, who want to service your life in some way. And your problem then becomes, how do I make my best decision amongst the quality options that I have? It's still a problem, but trust me, significantly higher than nobody wants me, right? So again, you're evolving in the scale of problems, still not easy, still have to make a decision, still have to choose one among the options, but at least you have choices. Fourth level of problem is I've chosen the kind of guy that I want. We're an exclusive relationship. So at that point, you stop being single. But the problem is, how can we deepen this relationship? How can we transcend each other's individual problems and become better lovers, become more gifted givers, and also enjoy and receive what the other has to bring to us? How can we grow spiritually, emotionally, physically, sexually with each other. That's, again, still a problem. Is it easy? No, it's actually hard, but it's more fulfilling than transcending the first one. So here's where you come in. I want you to be very honest with yourself right now and recognize, are you stuck at level one problems? Are you at level two where you're on your way, but you don't have the options yet, but you definitely know that guys are out there and you start at least seeing some light at the end of the tunnel? Are you at level three where you've done this and you've mastered it for a while, so you now have quality choices to choose from? Or have you chosen one really high quality choice consciously and you're going deep as you can, figuring out how to do it? Based on where you are is the quality of the experience you're having. So I highly encourage you, if you're one of those women who were saying, I don't want to experience love problems, to instead say, I want to graduate to the next higher quality problem that I can experience. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. And if it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the first line of the description of this video, you're going to find a link that will allow you to sign up for a free training that I'm sharing with you right now that will show you how to create more of these options, how to step into a higher quality love problem in a very systematic, pragmatic way. If what I'm saying to you right now resonates, sign up to this free training and follow it. So super simple, when you click on this link on the description of this video, you'll be taken to a page that has a yellow bar. Click on the yellow bar, it will ask you for your name and email. As soon as you enter them, you'll start watching this right away. Hope this is helpful to you, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.